dalam speech juga namakan impeach. Yang mana impeach, impeach time request.
It is a one man rule. Hebrews 9:11-28, akong basahan din eh. But Christ being come and high priest of good things to come by a greater and more perfect tabernacle not made with hands, that is to say, not of this building, neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood he entered in once into the holy place, having obtained eternal redemption for us. For if the blood of bulls and of goats and the ashes of an heifer sprinkling the unclean sanctify it to the purifying of the flesh, how much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God, purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God? And for this cause he is the mediator of the New Testament, that by means of death for the redemption of the transgressions of or that for the redemptions of the transgressions that were under the first testament, they which are called might receive the promise of eternal inheritance. For where a testament is, there must also be necessity be the death of the testator. For a testament is of force after men are dead, otherwise it is of no strength at all while the testator liveth. Whereupon neither the first testament was dedicated without blood, for when Moses had spoken every precept to all the people according to the law, he took the blood of calves and of goats with water and scarlet wool and hyssop, and sprinkled both the book and all the people, saying, this is the blood of the testament which God hath enjoined unto you. Moreover, he sprinkled with blood both the tabernacle and all the vessels of the ministry. And almost all things are by the law purged with blood, and without shedding of blood is no remission. It was therefore necessary that the patterns of things in heaven should be purified with this, but the heavenly things themselves with better sacrifices than this. For Christ is not entered into the holy place or holy places made with hands, which are the figures of the true, but into heaven itself, now to appear in the presence of God for us. Nor yet that he should offer himself often as the high priest entereth into the holy place every year with blood of others. For then must he often have suffered since the foundation of the world, but now once in the end of the world hath he appeared to put away sin by the sacrifice of himself. And as it is appointed unto men once to die, but after this the judgment, so Christ was once offered to bear the sins of many, and unto them that look for him shall he appear the second time without sin unto salvation. So this morning we're going to tackle about Old Testament salvation. Versus New Testament salvation. This is one of the great controversy and then great issue among so-called Christians and also among gituwag og mga non-Christians. When I say non-Christians, those are group of people nga dili sila saved. And among sigituwag mga Christian na tumatawag, kay maybe one of those, even though they are covenant, they practice covenant theology, their doctrine was is covenant theology, still naay mga paanay mga group diha nga they believe sigituwag og salvation naghimo ni Kristo sa cross without even gitawag og adding something sa maunga doktrina, although they could not put a distinction sa gitawag og two gospels, especially gospel of the kingdom and gospel of the grace of God. Dili sila makabutang og distinction, yana, they are not dispensationalist, but there are some people, a group of people, we call it some Christians, mga covenant theology nga nagtuo usab sa gitawag og gospel of Christ nga without adding anything, no? No sinner's prayer, no gitawag og no baptism gitawag. So ato makita didhi na kining gitawag karon nga controversy or issue about sa gitawag Old Testament salvation versus New Testament salvation. Dinhi nagka problema ang daghan kay nga mga denomination, and in fact subject on a more on debate, no, ang mao nga gitawag issue, because there are a lot of group, there are a lot of denomination follow the Old Testament pattern rather than the New Testament pattern sa gitawag og salvation. Now when we say Old Testament salvation versus New Testament salvation, we have to put some differences, and we have to look some differences aning duha ka mga butang. Importante kayo siya nga masabtan to nga do na good check kalainan in terms of sigituwag kining ituwag og implementation or sa program, sa plan, atong isugutan ni karon, plan, payment, then place, nga ilang pagatuan sumunay itong pagtagad karon. I believe daghan kayo mga issue about nini. Daghan kayo mga lesson about nini, but I choose three things nga atong i-discuss nini nga kabuntagon. Kung ato pa rin siyang i-discuss tanan, pati taasa ni, so I choose three things lang atong pagtagad. But maybe someday ito na pinin siyang dugangan about sa mga lesson, because at the end of this message, I'll be talking about sa introduction, sa other message na po nga ito ang pagkatunan sa maabot nga panahon. So, there are people nagituwag og sa ako na yung kasulti, so ato na yung resulta sa lesson, it is because it's taas na ang panahon ang may agi. So di ako magdugay about sa introduction. Ato ta sa pinag-content sa ito ang mensahe. So ato ta sa timeline. So this is the church. This is Israel. Or tawag na to ni nga law. And this is grace. Now So atong sugdan, we know that the Old Testament ends at the cross. So this is Old Testament. The New Testament starts with the cross, or starts at the cross. As sa ato ang natun-an, sa ato ang knowledge, nga ang New Testament or ang Old Testament nag-end sa Book of Malachi, then the New Testament starts with the Book of Matthew. Ang ato ang nahibal-an dati nga ang New Testament nag-start sa birth of Christ. So birth of Christ. Pero dili na mo'y starting point sa New Testament. So ato nang taga-agpagtagad, it is because so that atong butang sa insakto or sa proper nga timeline, nganong dili nag-start dari sa birth of Christ, no? Pero meron ay John the Baptist din hingi padalas Ginoo. Then Jesus Christ birth, tumikita din ha. So ganong dili sa birth of Christ nag-start ang New Testament? It is because of some reason nga itong mabasa sa Biblia. Atong tanawon una sa gituwag o Galatians chapter 4. Now, Galatians chapter 4, verse number, Galatians 4:4. Iwan ang pulong sa ginudya. But when the fullness of the time was come, God sent forth His Son, made of a woman, made under the law. So when Jesus Christ was born, he was born under the law. Ayon sa Biblia, he was not born under grace period. He was born under the law. Ato makita din ha. In verse number 5, the reason why is to redeem them that were under the law, that we might receive the adoption of sons. So ato nakita din si Kristo, natao siya under the law. So in other words, nagkinabuhi siya from his birth sa iyang ministry, that is under the law. Kanus araman ni Kristo, kanus araman natapos ang law? Ingon sa Bible, Christ is the end of the law. He ends the law. So ato makita din ha, giun sa pagtapos kay sa Romans chapter 10, then verse number 4. Romans chapter 10, verse number 4. For Christ is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone that believeth. So Christ is the end of the law. So we are talking about the law. The law is part of the Old Testament. And then, yun siya, ang pangutan na kanus agi end ni Kristo ang law. When Jesus Christ ended the law, it was a Colossians chapter 2, verse number 14, blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was against us, which was contrary to us, and took it out of the way, nailing it to his cross. So those ordinances, those laws that are under the law, yung sa Biblia, he nailed it to his cross. So, Old Testament, indeed, sa gitawag, at the cross. Christ ended the law sa gitawag Calvary's cross. So, ang timeline ni atong gisunod din he, that the Old Testament until Calvary. And then the New Testament starts at Calvary, at the cross. Because ato ang text nga itong gibasa dia in the book of Hebrews chapter 9, ato makita din ha, in the book of Hebrews chapter 9, sa ato ang text, balikan na to. Nagsulti ang pulong sa Ginoo din he, in verse number 16, yun ang pulong sa Ginoo na, for where a testament is, so New Testament, kung nasa daw itong testament, tingnan ang pulong sa Ginoo, there must also of necessity be the death of the testator. So without the death of a testator, there is no such thing as testament. There must be a death of a testator. It is necessary, yun sa Biblia, so that there will be a testament. Yun ang pulong sa Ginoo din ha. So kailangan kay na siya, nga naman, muna siya ang gitawag og pamatuod na dili mahimong usa ka testamento ang usa ka butang kung walay usa ka kamatayon sa usa ka testator. So New Testament started at the death of a testator. That's why there is a New Testament. So that's a timeline, Old Testament and the New Testament. So the New Testament or the Old Testament does not or did not end sa gitawag og Book of Malachi. So wala sa Book of Malachi nag-end ang gitawag Old Testament. Ang New Testament wala po nag-start sa birth of Christ, especially sa Book of Matthew, birth of Christ, wala diha nag-start. So klaro ang timeline sa Bible, sa Biblia ang atong gisunod, it should be the cross. It should be the Calvary's cross, the death of a testator. So ato ta sa gitubog og differences nga atong makita sa pulong sa Ginoo. Old Testament salvation versus New Testament salvation, dunay manag lahi nga gitawag mga butang atong tagaagpagtagad. First, atong tagaagpagtagad is number one, they have different plan to follow. So they have different plan to follow. So na iplano ang Ginoong managlahi ug maunay sundon sa mga, especially we are dispensationalists, so every dispensation there must be a dispensational salvation, as we called it. There's a heresy nga nagkatap among especially sa mga denomination that the Old Testament saints, no, the Old Testament people are looking forward to the cross. So they thought nga kining mga Old Testament saints din he, they are looking forward to the cross. Ingon sila. Kaya kining ingon po diri, kining mga New Testament saints looking backward to the cross. So tanaanan to kung that's gitawag og biblical. They say Old Testament prophets didn't, ato makita nga, they are looking forward to the cross. Pero atong tanaw sa Biblia, nga naman kaya tag-heresy, that's heresy. It is because the Old Testament prophets didn't understand what they were writing about in regards to the cross, in regards to sa gitawag og suffering, the death, the burial and resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ according to the scriptures. So wala sila makahibalo niya na, wala sila, although they talk about, they prophesied about that, but they didn't understand what was that. Kasi ibut pasabot niya na, tanahan to sa 1 Peter chapter 1 in verse number 10, ato makita din ha, 1 Peter 1:10-12. Of which salvation the prophets have inquired and searched diligently who prophesied of the grace that should come unto you, searching what or what manner of time the Spirit of Christ which was in them did signify when he testified beforehand the suffering of Christ and the glory that should follow, and to whom it was revealed that not unto themselves, unto whom it was revealed. Pero unsa isulti da? that not unto themselves, but unto us they minister the things which are now reported unto you by them that have preached the gospel unto you with the Holy Ghost sent down from heaven, which things the angels desire to look into. Now remember that 1 Peter was written AD 60. In other words, 15 years ago, when they have sa gitawag og Apostles' Conference in the book of Acts. So this book was written after sa gitawag og Apostles' Conference happened in the book of Acts chapter 15. Kung imong makita din ha sa ako ang akong Bible, sa akong Bible, Acts chapter 15 was written AD 46. Then, 1 Peter was written AD 60. So, the first epistle of Simon Peter was written around AD 60. So, this epistle of Peter was written AD 60. It was after, after 14 years ago sa dihang dunay conference or apostles conference nga nahitabo in the book of Acts, because very interesting or very necessary nga atong balikan ang mga timeline, mga events, kay diha nato makita nganong nasulat na ni Peter. Especially he is talking about here the gospel. Now, what gospel is this? I believe this is the gospel of the grace of God, because that was after, 14 years ago na ang nakalabay nga si Apostle Paul ni reveal sa book of Acts chapter 15 about sa gitawag gospel that was revealed to him by Jesus Christ nga iyang gi-communicate sa mga apostles sa Jerusalem, nga this is the gospel nga gi-reveal sa kuha ni Kristo Jesus, gi-reveal kaniya sa gitawag og desert sa Arabia. And then ingon sa pulong sa inyo din ha, nagsulti si Peter about sa gospel. So it is the gospel of the grace of God kaniyang gisulti din ni preach the gospel unto you with the Holy Ghost sent down from heaven, which things the angels desire to look into. So ingon sa Biblia, this gospel, this salvation, yung sa Biblia, was revealed not to them, but unto us. So, even the Old Testament prophets talks about this coming event, pero they didn't understand what was that event, unsa na ang klase event. So, yung sa Biblia, kining mga butanga, dili ni siya, wala ni mahibal-i even sa mga Old Testament prophets. Even si Peter before Acts chapter 15, nakasulat siya in the book of 1 Peter about the gospel. Pero before that, before Acts 15, ang iyang nahibaluan ng gospel is the gospel of the kingdom of heaven. That is why si Peter, ignorante siya sa mga panghitabo during sa earthly ministry of Jesus Christ. In fact, at makita din ha, nga si Pedro mismo, he tried to hinder sa maong plano ni Kristo by dying at the cross sa usa ka higayon. Tanaw to in the book of Matthew chapter 16. Matthew chapter 16. Diha ato makita nga si Pedro ignorante siya sa plano ni Kristo Jesus nga magpakamatay siya dito sa cross sa Kalbaryo. O ang iyang nahitabo niya na ato makita, yun ang pulong sa din ha. Matthew chapter 16 verse number 21. Tanaw dia. Tanaw akon, even si Peter, si Pedro, he was ignorant, even sa iyang 12 apostles, unahan to si Pedro, ignorante sila sa pagabuhato ni Kristo. In verse number 21, Matthew 16:21, from that time forth began Jesus to show unto his disciples how that he must go unto Jerusalem and suffer many things of the elders and the chief priests and scribes and be killed. So muna ang gisulti ni Kristo, gisulti niya nga muadto ko sa Jerusalem o nga musuffer kog daghang mga butang sa mga elders, Pharisees and scribes, yun siya, unya patyon ko, yun si Biblia, pagapatyon ko, and be raised again the third day. Unsa sulti ni Peter diya, if Peter knows this event, yun si Biblia, dili siya mubabag niya na. Pero sa inaitabo, in verse 22, then Peter took him and began to rebuke him, saying, be it far from thee, Lord, this shall not be unto thee. So kung si Pedro nakahibaloan ng plano sa Ginoo about sayang kamatayon dito sa cross sa Kalbaryo, that is why if you really believe nga the Old Testament is looking forward to the cross, and why was Peter obstruct or hindered that plan ni Kristo Jesus? If the Old Testament saints are looking for that event, looking forward to the cross, even si Pedro may hinder, may babag. You see, then Peter took him and began to rebuke him, saying, be it far from thee, Lord, this shall not be unto thee. Dili ni mahitabo. But he turned and said, Peter said unto Peter, get thee behind me, Satan. Thou art an offense unto me, for thou savorest not the things that be of God, but those that be of men. So ato nakita diha, gibadlong ni Kristo si Pedro. Although si Pedro ni badlong una si Ginoo, girebuke niya, pero gibadlong siya ni Kristo nga naman. Kaya na ay plano ang Ginoo sa kamatayon niya sa cross. So if the Old Testament saints are looking forward to the cross, nga nung ignorante, even ang iyang disciples mismo, ignorante. Kato si Pedro, uban niyang mga kauban, in the book of Luke chapter 18, verse 31-34. Kung pareha ba gihapon sila ni Pedro, at makita din na, Luke chapter 18, 31-34, atong makita din ha, nga, just like Peter, the other apostles, no, are ato makita ignorant of the event or sigituwag og Calvary's cross or kamatayon ni Kristo dito sa cross. Ato makita din ha in the book of Luke chapter 18 verse 31. Ingon diha, then he took unto him the 12. So yang gidala ang 12 mga disciples ni siya, apostles. He took unto him the 12 and said unto them, behold, we go up to Jerusalem, and all things that are written by the prophets concerning the Son of Man shall be accomplished. The Old Testament prophets are writing sige tuwag og mga events, future events, including sige tuwag og buhato ni Kristo. But sa akong eksulti, they do not understand what they are writing. They just written that prophecy because that's according to the working of the Spirit sa ilang kinabay, pero ignorant din sila nina. That's mystery. Di sila kahibalo nina. Nagsulat sila mga butang, nawa sila kahibalo. That is why God, the Bible calls that mystery. Kaywa sila kahibalo nina. Ayun, isa pulong sa Ginoo. The prophets concerning the Son of Man shall be accomplished. Verse number 32, for he shall be delivered unto the Gentiles, and shall be mocked, and spitefully entered, and spitted on. Verse 33, and they shall scourge him, and put him to death, and the third day he shall rise again. Verse number 34, and they understood none of these things. Kaklaro sa Biblia, in verse number 18, verse number 34, kaklaro sa Biblia, they understood not. Okay? Now, if they are truly looking forward to the cross, so I believe kung sila nag-look forward to the cross, so they have understood unsay pagabuhaton o unsa nang gisulti ni Kristo. But the fact na kining mga tawhana sa gipamulong ni Kristo, wa sila makasabot in Sharia in verse 34. And they understood none of these things. And the saying was hid. Hid from them. Neither knew they the things which were spoken. So, even the disciples, Peter and the rest of the apostles, they didn't understood sa unsay gisulti ni Kristo Jesus adto nila. So it is a heresy that the Old Testament saints, including mga apostles dira nga naglook forward to the cross, is absolutely heresy. The one who looks forward to the cross is no other than God. Ang Dios mo'y nag-look forward to the cross. But the people, they were not. They were not looking forward to the cross. Only God looks forward to the cross as one day, someday, my son will give his life as an offering para sa tanan. So it is God who looks forward to the cross. Pero ang tao, wala niya na. Old Testament sense. Tanahan to. So they have different plan to follow. Now, because I'm talking about that is a heresy. So now, let's along kita na ang ito plan to follow. How about silang righteousness na gitawag? The Old Testament plan of righteousness, okay? Righteousness in the Old Testament. So this is Old Testament righteousness. Dan ano to? Dan ano to sa gisulti ni Paul, na? Paul makes a comparison or made a comparison sa gituwag og managlahi nga righteousness. Both the dispensation. That is why importante yun kayo ang dispensation. If we do not study the Bible dispensationally, we will mess up sa gituwag og mga doctrine na to, di igyon magkasinan to. Now in the book of Romans chapter 9 verse number 30 to 32, iyon ang pulong sa Ginoo din, ha. Verse number 30, what shall we say then, that the Gentiles which followed not after righteousness have attained the righteousness? Iyon si Pablo. Ano sa mga pagi, ha, nga mga Gentiles nga wala magsulod sa gitawag og righteousness nga followed not after righteousness have attained righteousness, even the righteousness which is of faith. In verse 31, this is what we call a contrast, because we are talking about a comparison sa duha ka butang. So, yun siya diha, verse number 31, but Israel which followed after the law of righteousness. So, the Israelites people, they followed the law of righteousness. So, there is a righteousness based on the law. So, ang ilang righteousness sa Old Testament, it's all about following the law. Now, mo na ang ilang righteousness. O sa tanawang comparison, which followed after the law of righteousness had not attained, but Israel which followed after the law of righteousness had not attained to the law of righteousness. Even though nag-follow sila og righteousness, pero di ka nila ma-attain ang itong perfect righteousness. Pero gi-honor na sa Ginoo sa Old Testament times. Iyahan ang gi-honor nga kung dunay tao nga mag-follow sa gituwag righteousness based on the law, iyahan ang i-honor. Pero ato na masabtan nganong dili sila moadto sa usa ka lugar nga atuan ato unya, atong tanan unya. So, yun sa Apollos kino, wherefore, because they sought it not by faith. So, in other words, the Old Testament people, ang righteousness, it's not of faith. It's based on the law. Works. Iyon sa diha. But as it were by the works of the law, for they stumbled at the stumbling stone. So that is why kinahanglan i-end ni Kristo ang dispensation of law aron mosulod ang righteousness, no? Kini righteousness Japanese siya. Righteousness New Testament. Agitawag na to sa Bible, faith. Based on faith. So, kinahanglan i-end ni Kristo ang law aron matapos ang gitawag righteousness which is based on the law aron mosulod ang righteousness in the New Testament based on faith. That is what we call a contrast. Ang Israelites, the righteousness under the law based on the law. But the church age, the righteousness of the saints here is based on faith. Muna ato makita din ha. So ato tanawon karon unsa kuno ang ato ang gibasihanan sa faith. In chapter 10 verse number 11, verse number 5, imong napulong sigino diha. For Moses, is verse number 5, for Moses described the righteousness which is of the law. So si Moses ang iyang gi-preach dinhi at makita dinhi si Moses. Gi-describe niya ang righteousness under this dispensation of the law. Gi-describe niya the righteousness which is of the law, that the man which doeth those things shall live by them. So now, in other words, ang mga tao under this testament, under the Old Testament, they have to follow the Old Testament settings, the Old Testament laws, ato makita din ha. In order nga sila mabuhi or ma-deliver, ato makita di at ino na nga ma-deliver sila. Unlike sa gituwag church age, the dispensation of the grace of God, that period, the church period, our righteousness is based on faith, is through faith. And the object of our faith is no other than the blood of Christ, the death of Christ, ato makita din na, at the cross. So, umunay pinaka-objects ato ang faith. While din sa ilaha karon ang ilang righteousness is obedience to the law, works. Wala yung si Moses, works, instead of works, because they sought it not by faith. So, ang ilang righteousness dati is not of faith, but as it were by the works of the law. So, kaklaro kayo sa Biblia, din sa Old Testament, it's a work. In the New Testament, it's of faith. Works based on the law. Faith based on the gospel. The object of our faith is the gospel. The object of their works is obedience to the law. Muna ingon diri sa atong gibasa. So muna ang gituwag comparison sa Biblia. Og nganong ma-stumble man ang mga Jewish people, because nipadayon pa sila dito. Even under sa gituwag grace period, they still kept the law. That is why Christ became a stumbling block to them. Nga naman, kay kana nga program, ilang gipadayon. Nga gitapos na naman ni Kristo sa cross sa iyang kamatayon. So, nahimong stumbling block si Kristo. Kaywa nila nasabti nga naa ni gipasulod sa Ginoo because of the rejection. So ato nakita din ha. In the book of Ezekiel chapter 14 verse 14, klaro sa Biblia nga ang ilang righteousness, okay, ang ilang righteousness nag-deliver nini nga mga ipang-ingon diri nga mga tao. Now I quote this verse some of my videos on YouTube, some of my lessons, and ato makita din ha. Okay, in the book of Ezekiel 14:14, yan ang pulong sinasabi. Do these three men know what Daniel and Job were in it? They should deliver but their own souls by their righteousness, saith the Lord. Ingon ang Ginoo sa Old Testament times, yun siya, sa mga Old Testament sense, mismo ang Ginoo nagsulti, kining tulo ka tawo nga gi-mention dinhi, Noah, Daniel, and Job, iyon siya, they should deliver but their own souls by their righteousness that's based on the law. So makadeliver sila sa ilahang kalag, pinaagi sa ilahang maayong binuhatan. Although is pananaw sa Ginoo nga our good works are filthy rags in the sight of God, pero under the law, kanang imong binuhatan, gi-honor na sa Ginoo. Under the law. Gi-honor na sa Ginoo. Under the law. Now, ngayon ingon ang Ginoo nga filthy rags. Maubitaw na, nga naa sila'y adtuan, nga dili sama sa atuang giadtuan, especially karon nga mga panahon, in the church age, the church period, na ang sila adtuan. Ato ang tanawon niya. So ato makita nga ang ilang righteousness sa unang panahon based on the law, gi-honor na sa Ginoo. Mismo ang Ginoo nagsulti ni ana nga pinaagi sa ilang own or ilang righteousness. Not the righteousness of God. Ha? Nga sa atong panahon din he, gi-impute sa Ginoo. Although sa Abraham naa siya gitug imputed righteousness, pero ang imputed righteousness o ang gitug justification, imputation and justification dili nahitabo sa isa ka panahon. Unlike sa atuang panahon dinhi, the word imputation and justification happen at the same time. Unya ang gitawag og object sa atuang imputation and justification is the gospel. Pero dito sa ilaha sa iyang panahon dili atura nang masabtan sa umabot. So, iyon dia, gi-honor sa Ginoo ang itong righteousness based on the law. Tanawa, kung naabay mga tao, nga blameless at tubangan sa Ginoo, ha? Nga naman, mayon sila nga, walay blameless, dili ka maging blameless by doing the law in the sight of God. Tanaw na ito sa Biblia, kung wala ba'y tao, nga blameless at tubangan sa Ginoo based on the law. Okay, tanaw na ito. Naasag ituwag, part sa New Testament books, pero this is also part of the Old Testament books. Yan naman, it is before Calvary. Okay, in the book of Luke chapter 1 verse number 6. So it is before Calvary, so that's why this is part of the gituwag og Old Testament under the law. Okay, and they were both kinsa ning matuhanan ni kun atong tagaagpagtagad in verse number 5, Luke chapter 1 verse number 5, there was in the days of Herod the king of Judea a certain priest named Zacharias of the court of Abia, and his wife was of the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. In verse number 6, and they were both righteous before God. Okay, klaro sa Biblia, they were both righteous before God. So I believe gi-honor sa Ginoo ang righteousness. Nganong righteous sila tanong to? Nganong righteous sila before God? E usong pwede, walking, nganong righteous sila before God? It is because they are walking or they were walking in all the commandments. Sumpay dia, walking in all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord, blameless. So naigisulti sa Biblia nga naaday ay mga tao nga righteous under the law, blameless before God, righteous before God, and that righteousness is not based on faith on the cross, but based on the works of the law. So klaro kay sa Biblia nga naaday mga tao nga righteous. Nganong righteous sila? Because that was under the dispensation of the law. Pero kung ato na silang ibutang under this dispensation, yun sa Biblia, dili na i-honor sa Ginoo. Because under this dispensation of the grace of God, according to Romans chapter 3, verse number 19, yun sa Biblia, kung ato ng ibutang ng mga tawhana, under sa gituwag o dispensation of the grace of God, dili sila mahimong righteous before God. In the book of Romans chapter 3, verse number 20 or 19 and 20, now we know that what things soever the law saith, it saith to them that are under the law, that every mouth may be stopped and all the world may become guilty before God. Therefore, by the deeds of the law, there shall no flesh be justified in his sight, for by the law is the knowledge of sin. Kung kining mga tawhana atong ibutang sa gituwag dispensation of the grace of God, Zacharias and Elizabeth, ato silang ibutang sa dispensation of the grace of God, their righteousness which is based of the law, dili i-honor sa Ginoo. They could not be righteous before God, because in the sight of God, under the dispensation of grace, no one is justified by doing the works of the law. By the deeds of the law, no man shall be justified before God. But under the dispensation of the law, kung kana siya, aktibo pa ang imong works of the law, i-honor sa Ginoo, mahimo kang righteous before God. Klaro sa Biblia, and they were both righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord, blameless. Ato makita din ha. Klaro kayo sa Biblia, righteousness Old Testament based on law, works. Righteousness New Testament, faith in the gospel. Kini, works based on the law. Ato makita din ha. So, yun sa Biblia, even si Hezekiah, tanawa sa Hezekiah ha, ang sa iyang ipang-isulti si Ginoo sa diyang mahapit na siya mamatay. Hezekiah, ato makita din ha, ang iyang ipang-sulti, okay? Tanawa ang sa iyang gisulti. In the book of duha man iyang account ani pwede sa Isaiah. Pero tanan to ang sa Isaiah, pwede po sa gituwag og I think Second Kings or Chronicles, but Second Kings at makita diya. And in the book of Isaiah chapter 38 verse 1 and 3. In verse number 3 na siya gisulti diya. Sadang hapit na siya kuhaon sa Ginoo. In verse number 2, kay giingnan siya ni Isaiah, Prophet Isaiah, set thine house in order. Siya, ipahimutang na imong balay, himutang na imong panimalay, kay hapit ka na, mamatay. Grabe na nga, warning sa Ginoo. Sa yunan ka, set thine house in order, for thou shalt die and not live. Giingnan siya ni Isaiah na, grabe nga warning, direkta nga warning. Direkta rin sa kalibutan, na itaw magsakit. Ingon sa doktor, hadlok man taan isultihan o diretso kay basig, matigok ni kalit. Eh, nahinahin pagsulti nga imong kinabuhi, muna lang niya ang nahitab, marbilin, pila ka bulan, pila ka adlaw, hinahinahin yung sulti. Ayaw ka kakuan ha. Pero, kanyang propita ha, grabe ka na yung sulti. Direct to the point, yun ang puro, ingon siya. And si Kikai, ingon siya, set, the saith the Lord, ingon siya, and said unto him, in those days was Hezekiah, verse number 1, in those days was Hezekiah sick unto death, And Isaiah the prophet, the son of Amos, came unto him and said unto him, Thus saith the Lord, Set thine house in order, for thou shalt die and not live. Amo ginisulti ni Isaiah. In verse number 2, ato makita diha, then Hezekiah turned his face toward the wall. What is that wall? Dili wall si iyang balay. Kung di naa sila wall sa Jerusalem nga, dito nila nagipambutang ilang mga prayer request, ginabutang nila ito, muna ilang giampuan. Ang suksok na nila ito sa kitwag wall sa Jerusalem. So dito sila, atubang siya sa wall sa kitwag Jerusalem, and prayed unto the Lord. Verse number 3, ingon si Hezekiah, and said, Remember now, O Lord, I beseech thee, how I have walked before thee in truth and with a perfect heart, and have done that which is good in thy sight. Tanawar guda. So, gi-honor sa unang panahon, ang gituwag oga, unsay imong nahimo atubangan sa Ginoo. Sa atong gipangbasa ganyan na, sa sulti ni Moses, pinaagi sa pagsunod nimo sa gituwag righteousness works of the law, ma-deliver nimo imong kagalingon. Si Noah, si Daniel, si Job, gisulti sa Biblia, na through their righteousness based on the law, under the law, works of the law, iyan sila, ma-deliver nila ang ilang mga kalag. Kining taong atong gibasa karon si Elizabeth o si gituwag o si Zacharias and Elizabeth, they were both righteous in the sight of God, before God, and blameless in the sight of God. So, ato makita din hinga, under the law, kung kini siya active pa, no, gina-honor na sa Ginoo. Pero ato makita din ha, sariyang gitapos ka na sa Ginoo, ang law, dispensation of law, kaya na ata sa dispensation of grace, kanang mga butanga are no longer necessary para dinhi. It's another dispensation. That is why dispensation, ako nang kisulti, dispensationalism is very important to answer all the contradictions, it seems contradiction sa Bible. Kaya daghang mga tao nga, contradiction man ang Biblia. There's no such thing as contradiction sa Bible. But if you read without dispensational gitawag og mindset, you will encounter nga moingon ka, there are some contradictions sa Biblia. Anong naingon man ka nang na-contradiction sa Biblia? Because you are not studying the scripture dispensationally. Pagbasa ni mo anak nga book, uy, lahi lagi na dere. So, moingon ka, nga doon na-contradiction. Pero wala na siya contradiction if you follow rightly dividing. If you follow dispensationalism, walay contradiction sa Biblia. Ang Biblia, united na sila. Ha? Wala na nagka-contradict. They are all they pareha sila team, pareha sila og isay-isay, pero walay kuan diha, walay gitawag og contradiction diha. Ang imo na lang rightly dividing ang nagka-problema ka. Ayan naman. Kasi mo basa ka bersikulo. Ang imong bersikulo nga gibasa para sa tribulation period. Ya dili man to applicable nga bersikulo para sa body of Christ, the grace of God, the dispensation of the grace of God, because that verse is para sa tribulation period. Unya karon imong gibutang din ha. Kaya nakabasa ka na sa Biblia. Nakabasa lagi ko sa Biblia nga mawala ang kaluwasan. Ang imong gibasa, bersikulo para sa tribulation period. Yes, of course, ang salvation during this time, mawala ang salvation. You have to endure unto the end. Nya imong gibutang din eh. Di mo yung juga contradiction ang Biblia. Pero kung naa kay dispensational mindset, you study the Bible dispensationally, dili ka magmutan nga eh, di man para during a time, dili na applicable during a time, during the tribulation period. And there are verses na nagbasa ka, especially during sa ministry of Christ, nga mga versikulo para sa millennial reign of Christ. Nga imong gikuha. Di nagproblema ka, unsaon nimo pagkuan, unsaon nimo pagpahaom anang duha ka butang, di maglabad imong ulo, nandagang mga tao, ingon nga buang na mo tungkol ng Biblia. di ka mabuang ana nga imong gustong i-coincide ang mga bersikulo nga nagasumpaki. E gusto lang yung kang magkahiusa. Adili, gana siya pwede nga naman managlahi na nga dispensation. If you know what dispensation is all about, dili ka magproblema niya na. So dispensationalism is the answer of all the questions, or maybe we encounter some contradiction sa Biblia. So they are not contradicting those verses yung imong nabasa. Wala na mag-contradict to each other. Imuha na lang ng pagtuo nga nag-contradict. Ano man, you do not follow 2 Timothy 2:15. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. So, ato makita dia, they have different plan to follow. Kita na to. Based on the Old Testament time period under the law, righteousness works under the law, works based on the law, while righteousness in the New Testament is based on faith in the gospel. So, ingon anak ka, importante sa ang atong ginasunod nga plano. So, ang plan under the law, dili pwedeng imong i-apply sa dispensation of the grace of God. Kaya kung imo nang i-apply ang plan sa Ginoo under the law, unya, i-apply nimo din hi, munang daghan kayong debate. Makita ka sa mga plaza, bisan asang lugar na i-debate is the mga Baptist. Anong po yung mga Baptist na mag-apil-apil ang mga debate sa mga plaza? O uban pang uban diha. Daghan kayong mga debate, mahitabo nga naman. They force the plan under the law, ilang gina-force nga i-apply under sa gitawag grace period. No, yun sa Biblia, the dispensation of the law was ended dihas kamatayon ni Kristo sa cross Calvario. So, gitapos na ang dispensation of law. Gitapos ni Kristo sa iyang kamatayon sa cross. So that the dispensation of the grace of God ni start. So we are now under the dispensation of grace, and in fact we are at the last days. Upila ka days na nang nabilin karon, we do not know. Pero naa ta din hi ang mga panahon. Okay? So we are at the last days, ato makita din ha. And naa na ta sa gitawag apostasy. So we are at the last apostasy. Ano ang tumunong spelling? So, at makita din ha, naata din he, under the dispensation of grace, we are waiting for the rapture. Waiting for the rapture so that the tribulation period will come in. So, that's the plan. No? Ayaw i-force ang plan sa Ginoo sa under the law nga imong ipasulod diri sa under grace. Or ang plan sa tribulation period nga imong ibalik, wala pa rin itabo, pero imo nang gibutang din he, na magpuproblema ka. Di ka sabot sa Biblia. Ayag isulod ang plan sa tribulation period dere sa under grace. Under grace, mag-end during sa time sa rapture. So, ato ta sa ikaduha. Ikaduha. Kapitat ta sa oras. They have different payment to present now kung mo atubang ta sa kurtis Ginoo unsa nga payment ang atong ipresent si Ginoo dili ang atuang kagalingong payment kun dili unsa unsay gihimo ni Kristo sa krus sa Kalbaryo, it's the payment of his own blood. Now, Old Testament, ang tanawon unsay payment sa Old Testament times. Okay. Sa Old Testament, ang payment sa ila sa Ginoo nga dawaton, every time nga makasala sila, every time they sin against God, even sa sala nga makingunta nga, they are ignorant of that sin. Wala sila kaibalo nga ilan ang nahimo ang maong sala, pero nahimo nila. Pero unsay sulti sa Biblia, unsay gihatag nga procedure or gitawag og kapayaran sa ilahang mga mahimong kasalanan. Tanan nato in verse number 1. Leviticus 4:1 aton Andre. Souls who sins aton Andre. Any soul who sins. In verse number 1, and the Lord spake unto Moses saying, speak unto the children of Israel saying, if a soul shall sin through ignorance, o siya kay balo nga nahimo niyang kasalanan, siya against any of the commandments of the Lord concerning things which ought not to be done, and shall do against any of them. So ang sala dai nga pabuhat mahimo sa tao is against commandments sa Ginoo. So in other word, transgression of the law mao na siya ang sin. Iyon sa Biblia in the book of 1 John, sin is the transgression of the law. So if there are laws nag-exist, ang tao makakomitar siya og kasalanan. Iyon sa pulong sa Ginoo in verse number 3. If the priest that is anointed do sin according to the sin of the people, then let him bring for his sin which he hath sinned a young bullock without blemish unto the Lord for a sin offering. Yan yan. And he shall bring the bullock unto the door of the tabernacle of the congregation before the Lord, and shall lay his hand upon the bullock's head, and kill the bullock before the Lord. So sa unang panahon, ang payment sa ilahang sin is ang tao mismo, kung siya nakasala, magdala siya og bullock or any animal siya andal undid to sa priest, and atubangan sa priest, ang priest magdala sa iyahang isalod sa blood, ang mismo ang tao mo ay mugulgol mo ana siyang ulo sa mananap og iyang hiwaon ang diog sa mananap. Then iyang saluron sa priest ang blood, and the rest of the blood iyang ished. Kaya katong priest mo'y mutabang og dala sa iyahang blood gayang gisala, iyahang i-offer sa dito sa tabernacle. So mo na ang payment sa Old Testament times. So there's what we called atonement ang hitabo. There's what we called atonement. Okay? Even in the Old Testament, there's what we called atonement. Atumutang isgutan ang word atonement. Under the law, animal's blood. So that's the payment nga ilang i-present sa Ginoo nga, Lord, nakasala ko pero naay ako ang gituwag og payment, naay ako ang gituwag og offering, animal's blood. So mo na giingon si Ginoo nga buhaton, he shall lay his hand upon the bullock's head and kill before the Lord, and the priest that is anointed shall take the bullock's blood and bring it to the tabernacle of the congregation. And the priest, verse number 6, shall dip his finger in the blood and sprinkle of the blood 7 times before the Lord, before the veil of the sanctuary. Mo, grabe ning nga trabaho sa ilang sa unang panahon. The congregation, number verse 13, congregation nga nagkasala. Verse number 22, a roller, presidente o sa panang uban diha nga dagkong mga ranggo mo gyapon. When a ruler, verse 22, when a ruler hath sinned and done somewhat through ignorance against any of the commandments of the Lord his God concerning things which should not be done, and is guilty, mo gyapon dala siya og offerings, goat, a kid of goats and a male without blemish. Yeah, verse number 22, he shall lay his hand upon the head and the goats. There is a, you know, the priests or the people, at makita din ha, nga makasala, magiapon ang buhaton. In verse number 28, and of his sin, which he had sinned, come to his knowledge, then he shall bring his offering a kid of the goats, a female without blemish, for his sin which he hath sinned. And in verse number 35, and he shall take away all the fat thereof, as the fat of the lamb is taken away from the sacrifice of the peace offerings, and the priest shall burn them upon the altar according to the offering made by fire unto the Lord, and the priest shall make an atonement for his sin that he hath committed, and it shall be forgiven him. So ato makita din he, the Old Testament payment is through animal's blood. So there's what we call atonement in the Old Testament times. And that is the blood, animal's blood. How about the New Testament? This is Old Testament. Old Testament. How about atonement sa gituwag og New Testament? Ato may kita din, Jesus blood. In the book of Romans 3, ato, Romans 3, so different payment, atonement, nagitawag, Romans chapter 3, verse number, okay, Romans 3:25. When God had set forth to be a propitiation, verse 25, when God had set forth to be a propitiation through faith in animal's blood? No. Faith in his blood. So there's a propitiation. That means that the wrath of God was appeased. So the word propitiation is to appease God's wrath. Ang kapungot sa Ginoo mawala if there's a propitiation. There's an atonement. And that is in the Old Testament, animal's blood. And in the New Testament, under the dispensation of grace, is through the blood of Jesus Christ. If we have faith in His blood, you know, through the propitiation, through faith in His blood, to declare His righteousness for the remission of sins that are passed through the forbearance of God. So, atong nakita din ha, that our atonement, this is New Testament, our payment was made by Jesus' blood. Their payment in the Old Testament is through animals' blood. Pero sa sulti sa Biblia, this animal's blood could not take away sins. That is why sa ikatulong atong tagapagtagad, importante kaayo. Na sa ikatulong nga point din he, importante kaayo nga anong kinahanglan nila ang maong blood. And then it will bring us to another lesson someday nga akong pagadalon. So di na lang kung magdugay ni ini, it is because we know that the atonement of the Old Testament times under the law, under Old Testament patterns, ito makita din ha, based on animal's blood, Every time makasala sila sa Ginoo, makasala sila atubangan sa Ginoo, dala og animal's blood offered dito sa atubangan sa gituwag, dalon na sa pari, then ang pari mo imo offer na mo sprinkle ang blood dito sa gituwag og tabernacle. Every time they sin against God. So again and again and again and again and again and again, every time nga sila makasala, again and again, magdala sila atonement para sa ilahang sin. Karon wala na sa ato ang time. Di na tamo ato og pari aron mo halad ta dito pad pader sa pana priest ihalad di sa ko atong kinakasala ko. Wala na karon. It is because our once sacrifice nga atong giila is the sacrifice of Christ, the blood of Christ. Atong gibasa sa ato ang text kaganina in the book of Hebrews chapter 9. He made a one sacrifice for all. Iko sa Biblia. Na ato makita din he, di ko magdugay din ha. Nga ako rin ang balikon sa sunod. Number 3, they have different place to go. In before the cross, ato makita, there's what we call paradise. The Bible calls it Abraham's paradise. Or experience paradise. And this is what we call hell mga good gihapon eh, pero this is fire. Muni ang lugar sa impyerno. Kalayo na din ha. Well then, he is a place of paradise. So they have different they have different place to go. Now the Old Testament sense, the Old Testament people nga na atone tungod sa animal's blood, they went to paradise. Dito sila sa paradise padulong. Nga naman, sa ako na yung kasulti, this blood, this animal's blood could not take away sin. Their sins in the Old Testament times is just being covered. But in the New Testament times, our sins were gone. My sins are gone. We're totally gone. Both past, present, and future sins are already forgiven by God. Now, ito makita din he. Every time mamatay sila, padulong sila dito. Pero sa time sa gituwag under grace, the moment nga ang tao mamatay, nga na save siya, it is because of the gospel of Christ. We know that this is the gospel. This is the gospel. 1 Corinthians 15, 1 through 4, this is the gospel. 1 Corinthians 15, 1 through 4. So the moment nga ang tao ni believe sa gospel of Christ, 1 Corinthians 15, 1 through 4, that's the pure gospel. Kung maabot siya ang kamatayon, diretso siya padulong sa langit. Diri ang iyang destination. Pero ang Old Testament sense, kung mamatay siya, kung namatay sila dati, padulong sila dito sa paradise. Dito sila padulong. That's why si Kristo, ingon siya sa maong tao, malefactor sa ito sa cross. Ingon ang mao nga malefactor, usapan eh, gamit-gamiton nga po ni sa mga tao nga, ingon nga, oh tanawa, faith alone, ay daghang kay mga tao na ingon nga, ang kaluwasan is faith alone, dari sila, faith alone, gikan sa Genesis, padulong sa gituwag to sa Revelation, faith alone, dili na faith alone, that's why magamit ang gituwag o malefactor, nga giingon ni Kristo sa cross Calvario, wa makita unsa kadako ang gihimo, while dito siya sa cross. No, yun si Kristo, yun sa mga tao, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom. Sa sulti ni Kristo, today thou shalt be with me in paradise. Wala nagsuwala ni Kristo nga, oh, I will bring you to my kingdom because the kingdom is not yet, wala pa ang gituwag kingdom i-establish, ma-establish. Ang yung question diha, kini, I believe, isa ni siya ka hudiyo ni nga tao because kahibalo siya sa kingdom. He knows what kingdom is all about. Kahibaw siya. In the book of Luke chapter 20:23. In verse number 42, and he said unto Jesus, Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom. So I presume that this man was a Jewish, he was a Jewish man, at tumakita din he. Ano man, he knows about the kingdom. Iyon siya. Lord, when thou comest into thy kingdom, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom. So I believe he is a Jew. Because only the Jew nga naay mindset about sa gitwag coming kingdom. Daotan siya, pero yung sa isulti ni Kristo. Today, verse number 43, and Jesus said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, today thou shalt be with me in my kingdom. No, what is Christ in my kingdom? Yet today thou shalt be with me in paradise. So, ang maong na kaoban ni Kristo sa krus sa Kalbaryo, gilansang, ingon si Kristo, I will not bring you to the kingdom. It is because it was not yet established. Wa pa na ma-establishar. It is just mo abutay pa na. Pero I will bring you instead to paradise. This is under beneath the earth. Ilawom sa yuta ang maong location ini. So gidala sa ito ni Kristo. Iyon sa Biblia. This is a temporary place para sa mga safe ng mga tao. They were not safe just like us, but they were just safe there waiting for this event. So, gidala siya, I will, today, thou shalt be with me in paradise. Ang importante kayo ang gituwag o wording sa King James Version, wala siya gidala dito sa kingdom because wala pa ang kingdom ma-establish. Gidala siya ni Kristo dito sa paradise. So, they have different place to go. Ang mga Old Testament sense, padulong sa paradise. But the New Testament sense, yung mamatay, padulong dito sa langit ng gituwag. So, they went to heaven when they die. So ato makita din hikaron. Nganong tuwa sila sa paradise? Nganong wa sila dito adto ditso? Nganong dili sa parehas dato nga ditso sa langit? Nganong adto pa sila dito? It is because the perfect sacrifice of Christ was not yet happened during sa ilang time. So they waited for this event nga mahitabo aron sila makaadto sa langit. So ato makita in the book of muni akong atong kun-an sa umabot ng mga panahon. In the book of sa atong text gibasa in the book of Hebrews, Hebrews 9 verse number 15 iyo diha. For this cause, he is the mediator of the New Testament, that by means of death, for the redemption of the transgression that were under the first testament, that means Old Testament. So there will be a redemption of the sins under the Old Testament, the transgressions of the people under the Old Testament period. Iyon siya, iyahadin ang i-redeem of the transgressions that were under the first testament, they which are called might receive the promise of eternal inheritance. Ito makita din he. So ang nahitabo ni karon the moment nga si Kristo namatay dito sa cross sa Kalbaryo, those people in this paradise nga naghimo og mga righteousness based on the law, they went to this paradise waiting for the perfect redemption, the blood of Christ, because the only thing that saves, take away sins, is the blood of Christ. Yes, kung maingon ta nga, we are saved, the same thing in the Old Testament and then versus New Testament, Old Testament, New Testament. Same ang ato ang salvation. Yes, maingon ta, yes. Pero sa timeline nga atong gisunod, wala sila ma-save based on the faith di silang kinabuhi, nagpaabot pa sila pila ka mga panahon dito sa gitwag paradise, hangtod sila makakaplag sa perfect na salvation, eternal redemption ang gitwag sa Biblia through the death of Christ. In other words, ang pangutana din ha, they were saved, or di man tama tawag saved sila in the place called paradise based sa ilang mahimo, based sa gitawag pagsunod sa balaod, works. Kita, saved kita by faith, diretso sa langit. Sila, based on works, padulong sa paradise, waiting for the perfect redemption of Christ. So, ang nahitabo, when Jesus died on the cross, the blood of Christ retroactively affects those Old Testament sins and sacrifices nga atong makita. Ang maapektuhan lang sa blood of Christ sa mga Old Testament sins kadtong na ay mga blood atonement. Pero kadtong mga tao sa Old Testament times nga nangamatay, nga napakialam sa atonement, blood atonement sa animal's blood, wa sila'y marking sa blood of the animal or animal's blood, diretso sila sa impyerno, mamatay sila nga padulong sa impyerno, nga wa sila'y atonement sa blood. Pero katong nay mga tao nga naay atonement sa blood, animal's blood, padulong sa paradise, because maunay tan-aon sa Ginoo nga sa dang mamatay si Kristo sa krus sa Kalbaryo, mautoy tan-aon niya nga naabay markings sa animal's blood sa Old Testament up to the book of atong itawag din hi book of Genesis, balik sa book of Genesis atong makita din ha sa time na ni Adam. Kung naay mga blood atonement din ha nga tumakita, kadtong mga blood atonement, maoto ang marking, bali, itanaw sa Ginoo para ang blood of Christ. The blood of Christ retroactively affects sa mga offerings, sa mga Old Testament sins. So that's the only way. So ang ato ang sunod niya tumakita di ha, how the blood of Christ affects sa mga Old Testament sins. They were saved just like as we are through the blood of Christ, pero managlahi nga pamaagi. Kinahanglan silang mo-obey sa law, kinahanglan silang mo-offer og animal's blood, kay kundi sila mo-offer og animal's blood, ang blood of Christ dili pwedeng mo-apekto sa mga tao sa Old Testament sense, because when they died, kung ang mga Old Testament sense na mamatay nga walay blood, animal's blood, why atonement, padulong dito sa impyerno. Pero katong naay mga atonement, animal's blood, padulong sa paradise, then the blood of Christ, mooy mo, ni atong itawag retroactively affect sa ilang mga sacrifices dati. So their transgressions were totally forgiven sa diyang si Kristo namatay dito sa krus Kalbaryo. Pero sa ilang animal's blood, it was just a covering. It was just a covering. Dili ni siya mao ang perfect redemption. The perfect redemption is the blood of Christ. One day we will be talking about how the blood of Christ affects Old Testament sins and also future sa gitawag og future sins. Atong dili sa atong panahon, directly affects through faith in the blood. Diretsog epekto ang atuang ang maong blood ni Kristo sa atong kinabuhi. That's why, kung mabot ang kamatayan sa Kristuhanon din hindapita under the dispensation of grace, diretso sa langit, yan naman. At niipikto, na gihimo naman ni Kristo ang final or perfect sacrifice para sa tanan. which is His blood. So that's why katong mga tao nga nasa paradise, kikuha na Kristo because nahuman na, it is finished, it is done, the gospel is being preached to them, giumana ni Kristo ang maayong balita, giwali niya din sa gitwag sa mga tao nasa paradise, according to 1 Peter. After that, 3 days after gidala niya, there was a resurrection happen sa mga Old Testament saints, gidala ni Kristo ang maong mga saints padulong dito sa gitawag o langit. So that is the first resurrection na tumakita. When Jesus Christ was resurrected, gilubong siya. So kining matuhana, gidala ni Kristo dito sa langit. Nga naman, tapos na ang payment, ang blood of Christ. Naula na. Perfect redemption ang gitawag. Eternal redemption ang gitawag, gihimo na ni Kristo sa krus sa Kalbaryo. That is why sa atong panahon karon, sa ato very simple ang kaluwasan. It's faith in the blood, believing the gospel of Christ. Christ did everything on the cross for our salvation. Gihimo na ni Kristo ang tanan dito sa krus sa Kalbaryo para sa atong kaluwasan. Sa panahon nga naa kita sa dispensation of the grace of God. Salvation is a gift. Salvation is freely given in this time period because salvation was already done by Christ by dying at the cross, by shedding His blood, because there's no shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. We were redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. So na-save kita, pinagi sa iyang dugo. Wa kita ma-save kay maayo tang tao. Dire mga panahon na pwede sila ma-preserve dito sa kitawag paradise sa ilang paghimog maayo. Pero dili ni mo na pwedeng dal-on dito. Kay ang kaluwasan karon dinhi, diretso na kay si Kristo na ang nihimo sa ato ang kaluwasan. Si Kristo na ang nibayad sa ato ang kabayaran. Mao ang dugo niya. The only thing na madawat sa amahan is the blood. Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. That is why in verse number 12, katapusan ng versikulo in Hebrews chapter 12, Hebrews chapter 9, verse number 12, neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by His own blood, He entered in once into the holy place, having obtained eternal redemption for us. Kitagaan kita og eternal redemption. Pinaagi sa iyang dugo. Ngayang giula dito sa cross sa Kalbaryo.